Boothbay Harbor, an idyllic coastal town located to the south of Bath as the crow flies, and where I vacationed as a child. I remember coming here with my parents, staying in a small cottage my grandparents own, and on the drive, one thing always caught my attention. This right here is the Boothbay Harbor Civil War Monument, erected in 1879 right here at the entrance to Boothbay along Route 27. Originally, it cost the town around $2,000 in 1879 money, which is over $60,000 now. It is a granite statue, depicting a Union soldier sitting atop a pedestal. Inscribed upon the monument, it reads, "Erected in the memory of the 256 soldiers and sailors from Boothbay Harbor in the War of 1861-65. The world can never forget what they did." The basin features a bed of flowers, and frequently features American flags planted in the ground around the statue when certain patriotic holidays are close. Originally sculpted by the Hollowell Granite Company, a company known for its granite quarries and sculpting, this monument is somehow a source of minor controversy for the small Maine town. An article in the Boothbay Register from 2018, titled "Resident Complains About Civil War Monument's Condition," we see the perfect example of small-town drama. A singular resident believes that the town made a monumental mistake in how it maintained the Civil War Memorial this year. The complaint, you may ask? The grass didn't grow too well after the winter, leaving the grass surrounding the monument looking barren and bare.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
That's the complaint. Simple as reseeding the plot again and hoping the grass grows. The article continues. "We owe it to our veterans. This should have been done in the spring, or at least by Memorial Day or the 4th of July. It still isn't done. I don't know what's on the remaining Route 27 punch list, but I think growing some grass there should be the first thing." Perhaps the funniest part of this whole debacle, however, is that this area was already reseeded earlier in the year. The grass just hadn't taken. However, there's something sinister in the comments of this article. Something profoundly disturbing. And that something is someone who doesn't understand the monument movement. Quote, read 1V. "It's probably time to just retire the monument to a museum. It is, after all, politically incorrect nowadays, and most millennials have no idea what the war was about. Retire the past and look to the future." Now, first off, I'm a Zoomer, so that's one strike on you already. And also, that's not what the monument movements are about. No one in their right mind wants Union monuments removed. In fact, I'm in favor of more monuments commending the valor and deeds of those that fought against slavery and for the preservation of the Union. No. What people want removed are monuments that glorify a rebel cause that were erected after the war in an effort to intimidate African Americans into knowing their place. This comment, in claiming that I have no idea what the war was over, manages to fundamentally misunderstand its own argument. Now, the thread takes a turn that requires some elaboration. Another commenter, Mr. Oh Wow, says that we should give it to a Paul Colombe. Now, Mr. Colombe is a local philanthropist who now owns a large chunk of town. He's done some pretty commendable things. He's a proponent of preserving historical sites, among other things, something that I can fundamentally agree with as a historian. However, that's where our similarities end. He purchased the Boothbay Harbor Country Club, seen in this wonderful picture, and priced many local residents out of being able to visit their own local golf course, along with other issues that are causing the animosity between this commenter and Mr. Paul. The comments continue, with Reed replying, "Great idea, it would look good at his golf course's 19th hole." And Oh Wow countering that it should be a bowsprit on a yacht. Now, I for one would love to see a granite statue weighing God knows how much on the front of Mr. Kolum's yacht. However, I think that may have some sort of adverse effect on the buoyancy of the boat. Just a hunch. Not an engineer, I'm a historian. However, this monument remains here in Boothbay after 145 years and stands as a monument to the Union cause and all those from this small town that fought for the preservation of the Union and to bring down the rebel cause.
We will drive the rebel forces from their strongholds to the sea, and we'll live and die together in the army of the free. Rust beneath inaction, we may sink beneath disease. The summer sun may scorch us.